structures were built according to astrological data. The Mayan observatory stands on three terraces. Its shape is virtually identical to that of a modern observatory. Look closely at this statue. A man, in the confines of a small room, seems to be operating a lever. There are strange projections on his helmet, resembling antenna. This pyramid is actually a huge calendar in stone. Each of the 365 steps on its four stairs represents one day. See the winged god Kukulkan. We are told that he too came from the stars and returned to them. He was supplanted by the bloody warrior god Shakmol. He carried a tray before him to receive offerings of human hearts. In times of drought, the people were led in a pilgrimage to the sacred well called Cenote. Young maidens were sacrificed here to the rain god, flung into the deep, murky waters. There was no escape from this sinister well. It is a perfectly round crater in the rock. It couldn't possibly have been formed naturally, nor could human hands alone have scooped it out. It resembles a crater made by the exhaust gases of a very powerful rocket engine. Among the many unanswered questions posed by the traces of Mayan culture is the following. 600 years after Christ, the entire Mayan population departed, leaving towns, temples, and pyramids, the fruits of great labor behind, and moved northward to start from scratch. However, there is no trace of war, plague, famine, or sudden climate change at that time to account for the move. There are 16 cities in Mexico with a population of more than 100,000. One of these is Mérida. The descendants of the Maya live here. They still have their own language, derived from the ancient Mayan tongue. They are perhaps the most peaceful people in Latin America. Their faces today still have the haunting beauty of their ancestors, preserved for us in stone. Leaving Mérida, we fly over a vast swampland to arrive at La Venta. This is where we find dozens of these stone heads, right in the middle of the swamps. Each weighs about 200 tons. There is no quarry within 80 miles, only jungle. The same question arises again. How were these mammoth statues carried over the marshy terrain? Days of delay precede our audience with the winged god of Palenque. He is not an easy gentleman to see. A dome of sweltering humidity hangs over the virgin forest of Palenque. Along our path to the sacred city of the Maya, we pass the cadavers of cattle with swarms of patient vultures wheeling overhead. After 8 refusals, we are finally granted official permission to film this ancient celebrity. The sealed sepulcher is open to us for a brief half hour. Up a steep flight of stairs, then down into the even more stifling dampness of the interior of the tomb. And there he is, captured for the first time on film, the winged god of Palenque. What the lens sees is so stunning that we must examine the details separately.
We see a man seated in a capsule, intently watching something. His hands seem to be operating some undefinable controls. His foot is pressing a pedal. At the rear of the capsule, we see jets trailing flames behind them. Isn't this a typical position for an astronaut, as we so well know it today? He seems to be dressed for the job, in trousers with a broad belt. A sort of jacket, tight-fitting at the wrists, like coveralls. The chair is well upholstered to absorb the shock of acceleration. A figure before controls, also dressed like an astronaut. Another jet trailing flames.
This stone deity, say the Maya, represents Kukulkan, who came from the stars and returned there. Easter Island emerges from clouds of smoke and rain. Today, the natives still call their island Matakitirani, which means eyes looking up to heaven. The neighboring atoll is called the Island of the Bird People. Here we see them, creatures with human bodies and the heads of birds. Are these really birds' heads, or do they just seem that way to the natives? They could also be helmets equipped with oxygen masks.
Legend has it that in prehistoric times, flying people came to the island amidst fire.
This is Makemake, the god of the island. Today, about 2,000 people live here. There were never more than 4,000 natives at one time. All scholars agree on this point.
This being established,